Greetings, YouTube. This is BJ Black. And today I'm doing my final part of my Let's Play of Super Meat Boy. So, let's get into this. Appropriately, this is called The End. Pretty short chapter. This will be easy. I'm expecting... what? Oh, are those grassy-looking things down there? Are blades. Okay, locked that way. Oh, great. Gack. Evil grass blades. So now I can get up over there as well. So which way do I need to go? I guess that's my answer. No way to get up there. And now that I have done by process of elimination. Oh, like I want to go through that. I don't have a choice, do I? Okay, it looks fairly simple. I'll be able to do it. No sweat. Ah. Well, I'm far from being any kind of A plus. Great. Set me right next to her again. And the key just a few squares away. And I have to go through hell and back in order to do it, huh? That was close. What's okay. This isn't as hard as you might think. Death bombing is kind of a pain, though. Okay, here we go. This is the end. I'm here. Time to finish this. Oh, easy. And I dropped somewhere safe. Good. No, that's not a one square wide platform with a background below it. It is a one square thick with more squares behind it. This is what I get for not playing Super Meat Boy for a day. safety. No, don't jump high enough to get up there in one jump. Zero deaths to saw blades. I missed the chapter title. I'm thinking these are going to be pretty good chapter titles, for the most part. And I'm just being patient now. Why would I go in that murky? Great, now what have I accomplished? Another one with another key, and it's going slightly faster, as if that has any bearing on whether I can do it or not. Slightly faster does not matter to me. If you want it to be hard, put it ridiculous. This is a little bit harder. First try. Is this really supposed to be the ultimate chapter where I die a million deaths? No. Sure. Whoop. Double saw blade rotators. Does anybody actually die to this kind of thing at this point in the game? Okay, this I can see being deadly. Got it! Omega! This is where I jump over here. Get through there. And... okay, I think I actually need to jump on this. I think I actually need to wall jump here. Bam. Get in here. Better boost. Alright. Now I can get out the top over here. How do I get up there? Oh, I know. I've done this before, actually. Just for some reason, I wasn't expecting it to be so simple. Alright, now we get into the next building. This. Okay. But while I was getting killed, I saw what I needed to do, so this should be easy now. Yeah.
So close.
So obviously you saw what I was trying to do there. Butters the lag. I think this is the penultimate level. Just this and then a boss fight. Whoa. I could have died. In fact, I probably will a few more times. Hey, I was thinking, do you remember Littlehorn? The big pattern boss in the hell level? I wonder if he is somehow the bodies of all the meat boys that died in your adventures. Because if I'd been paying attention, I would have noticed he's made of meat boys of some sort. Alright, time for me to shut up and concentrate on the platform hopping. I've played worse games than this. Nothing comes to mind off the top of my head, but I've played worse games than this. The thing about jumping around these saw blades on a wall is you need to not hold against the wall when you press jump, but then immediately press towards the wall again. If you don't let away from the wall, you won't get far enough away to escape the saw blade. But if you don't press back towards the wall, then you'll go flying off. Get back to that wall. Those times I've gotten that far, I've usually forgotten to press back towards the wall soon enough. And like I said, you get launched. Also, jumping too soon is death. That was a picture-perfect jump. Yeah. That was just bad timing. Bad everything, right? This kind of reminded me of my playthrough of the I Want to Be the Guy level. Or just slowly getting the hint. And getting a little further each time. Except the times when you die early, which is pretty frequently. It's a punishing game. Now I can't jump too high, which I usually do. And I can't jump too low, that time I hit the gap in the ceiling, that could be used in a speedrun. Which is not really something I'm going to concern myself with, but it's an interesting tactic. Why does Meat Boy jump so much higher when he jumps up a wall? I mean, I can only jump like 3.5 squares off the ground. But if I'm one square up against the wall, I can hit that upper saw blade here, no problem. Practice jumping around this saw blade a little bit so that I don't get too much extra height. I say to myself immediately before I get myself killed that I still need the practice and I'd rather not have to go the long way to do it. The position of that saw blade is slightly different from the one I have to jump around, but it's close enough to work with. That wasn't bad. I mean, yeah, I died, but it wasn't bad. You know, I bet you could do the same kind of jump going straight up this wall and save a little time there as well. Alright. I tried it a couple times, maybe I've got it. Who am I kidding? You didn't see that. I think I pressed the jump button a little too long. If it were here, I would be dead. Ready to that. I wasn't expecting to just miss the platform like that. No, it wasn't the platform I missed, was it? Before, I've always hit that wall before going through. Keeping my momentum phased me. Almost there. Hopefully there isn't going to be anything hard after that, because I don't want to have to do that several times. I mean, succeed at that several times, I'm already doing it. Succeeding at things is a lot harder than doing things. So much close. I can't believe it. I just tried something new there that was pressing against the wall the whole time I was jumping. Which didn't work on the first one you can see over on the left because it sticks out further from the wall, but at this one, you do jump far enough from the wall to successfully do that jump while holding away from towards the wall. Man, I wish I'd known that. Here's another chance I get to do the same kind of thing. If I don't die. Oh. Huh. Okay. There's a key block there, and a key I need to get there. That shouldn't be too hard once I get inside. I mean, honestly, I've done this so many times. Getting down is another thing. Timing is your friend. Do good timing and everything works. Man, I feel stupid for doing it wrong that whole time. Hey. Well. Let's stick with the way that I know works, and I'm pretty good at. Oops. I guess I need to fall down without touching the walls, because jumping off of a wall will send me flying into death. So close. Man. I get the feeling on that second jump, if I'm at just the right height, I will miss the platform entirely. But for the most part, you'll hit all the time. Feeling I could do it, grab that wall real quick and jump off, but change direction in midair. You have to hold towards the wall in order to not jump straight into the saw blade on the opposite side. I think I'll stick with the other way for a few at least. I think it's possible. Haha. Come on, tell me I'm done already. I'm done. So easy. This final part, they just give you practically a freebie. Look at the hordes of them. A dozen or so will be lost in this room. There's still so many. Many, many will die here. I'm down to a half a dozen. Now I'm down to 5. 3. And there's the last one. Alright, boss, Dr. Phoenix, we are done here. Well, after the boss battle, of course. We start by getting smacked down. Great idea. Well, now everything happens in cutscenes like it does normally. Huh. That's interesting. There's saw blades ahead of me. Uh-huh. And Dr. Vetus is there. His homing rockets are about as bad as the regular homing rockets. Oh, I guess I can't wait around for that. Oops. That was a mistake. I think it's safe to say that was a mistake. Okay, this should be pretty easy. Ha. Lag. But this lag didn't kill me. Usually it does. Now how are you gonna get out of there, Dr. Fetus? Oh wait, you're invulnerable to the crap I have to do. Oops. Should have known better, but that's a pretty big category, considering how often I do things I should have known better. Alright, jump up here. Yeah, keep firing that rocket launcher, it really matters. Now what? Okay, great. This isn't horrible at all. Should have been better than that. I mean, that was a straight up fail on my part. Hurry up and wait. Yep. You gotta get the timing down or else you die. Well, even if you do have the timing down, you'll probably die. A couple times. You know, Dr. Fetus is probably the least dangerous thing in this level. I mean, you have to deal with him once. Once you've seen him shoot his weapons off a couple times, you're pretty much good. I think I hit the same saw blade I hit before. I need to wait just a minute longer. Slow-moving box I'm stuck in. Okay, hit the top, don't do it. Hit the bottom, now. Ha! I got it figured out. I pressed the jump button. I really did. I'm just in a hurry to get myself killed. Now jump when it hits the bottom. Maybe a little after it hits the bottom, huh? Oh, interesting. I think it starts... No, probably not. Forget what I was about to say. Why was I just mesmerized watching Dr. Fetus? I should have been paying attention to what I needed to do. Okay. Hits the bottom, then jump. Perfect. Oh, so close. Bottom and drum. Look at that. A little late that time. Do I cut it too close with that particular saw blade? I'm always looking ahead. I don't look at it as I pass it, but it sometimes seems like I'm really freaking close. You know, I think his rocket launcher only fires directly forward. And the curvedness... Now. And the curviness it exhibits is always after the shot. Okay, great. Is this the final showdown? I know what I need to do. I thought it was the rocket launcher would blow up the wall, allowing me to get at the switch, but no, it was another switch. Yay! Win! If you're going to press a button, press it with your pointer finger, not your middle finger. So what do I... So is there actually anything I need to worry about? Oops. Okay, remember the run button. Press the run button. But not too early. Yeah. So it's self-destructing, but I'm not, you know, in any kind of hurry or anything. Okay, lag, don't do that to me. Now we learn if you've been paying attention to your lessons throughout the game. I know it's possible. That was me pressing the wrong button. And pressing too late. If I press against the wall, I don't jump far enough out, so I need to jump while not pressing against the wall for just a moment, but not so far as to fling myself. Okay. Here I go. There I went. Something funny about that saw blade I've got so many times too is it's not getting any blood on it like most saw blades have always done. Ooh, I... So close. Okay, do I need to press that button? It's just sitting there saying, press me. But on the other hand, it could be a trap. It just makes everything worse for me. You know, this seemed so easy when I was coming through going forwards. But now that I'm going backwards, it's all kinds of hard. How unfair is that? No, that's not a button at all, is it? It's just a brick, see? Haha, I'm immune to explosions. what I need to do is get up that first shaft, or do I need to go the second? The first. Alright, doing that much better now. Hey, that is more saw blades than there was the first time. That is unfair. Patently unfair. What? Seriously though, when did Dr. Fetus have time to add those extra saw blades? And don't tell me it was because of the button he pressed. I've seen so many buttons and I'm not going to buy that they just do whatever damn thing he feels like. No, actually I don't have a choice, do I? Wait. This level scrolls vertically as well as horizontally. Which it didn't do when we were actually when we were doing his part. Because I can't jump high enough to get into the first shaft. Alright. Awesome. Forgot to do the right thing there. This level was also scaled out a bit more when Dr. Venus was present. Whoops. That could have killed me. And that did kill me. Whoa! I forgot those things were there. I messed up there. That one saw blade. It's out to get me. Falling to my death. So the easier way would have been to go left instead of right. Whoa. close. Now that I'm here, all right, achievement unlocked to the end. Things are falling apart. Oh, come on. Meat Boy has even died in cutscenes. So, hey, it's the Turd Boy. Yeah, thanks for the wink. That's too bad, I guess. I mean, he's still a giant turd and I don't care, but I guess that's too bad. Alright, Hero gets the girl. While everybody else dies. Wait, what? And there you have the main game of Super Meat Boy. Obviously, there's a bunch more collectibles and things. Ah! Everybody loves a running joke. So obviously, there's tons of collectibles. There's a whole dark world I didn't even show you. What the hell? So now we're going to go through all the bosses or something? Or all the worlds and or bosses. The next one would be Turd Boy. Oh yeah. Wait. So, and the toilet. Well, it's not everything can respawn. I mean, even in cutscenes, so. No, those were the parts of the giant Littlehorn. Littlehorn was his name. Oh, jeez. At least the noise it makes isn't as obnoxious anymore. But more to the point, the things I've not done is collect all the bandages, go through the dark world, which is basically all the levels the same as before, only much, much harder. And I haven't done the warp zones, which are some horrible things.
The end!
Yeah, the dark world. I read ahead a little. In the dark world, you have the same 5 levels, only much, much worse, and then the boss level again. Which will give you the true end, or something. I will not be doing that on camera, because honestly, I'm not much for this kind of thing. Well, in addition to the dark world, you also have an extra world at the end. So, I'll show you the dark world real quick. It looks like this. Wait. In order to unlock it, I need to beat 85 dark world zones or something. There's 105 of them, so that's most of them. As you can see, I have actually gone and beaten. Wait, what? Even the stages are unlocked. The boss being unlocked, nothing. Even the stages are. I don't even know how to unlock them. Oh, duh, I do know how to unlock them. Need to remember my buttons. Those levels that you complete with an A+ rating, you get to play in the dark world. Since I didn't get A+ on any of these, I don't get any dark world in this chapter. In other chapters, I've got A+s all around. But anyway, this is the end of my Let's Play, so I hope you enjoyed it. Although, it's a 6-year-old game, so I don't think anybody's watching me. In any case, See you later, YouTube.